Hello, I'm Mr. Rumi. You're a retired lecturer in metallurgy. I'm a scientist. I'm a new skin. Haven't drunk the old wine of the dead letters as they do it in the universities and colleges. And once you have drunk the old wine, you desire it, not the new. And you become useless skin, good for nothing. Old wine, skin full of old wine, cannot take the new wine on top of it, because what applies to flesh, the opposite to spirit, or what they see, opposite to perceive. So they are incapable of perceiving, and they just go by the dead letters at the universities and colleges. They teach dead letters. If you go against them, you cannot be a professor or anything like that. You will be thrown out because you are out of tune. Gospel is for 1 in 1,000 and 2 in 10,000. So gospel is not that cheap. And my elder brother, Royal Shah Shams Tabrizi, who was son of Allah, he tried to introduce this new wine to the Maulvis and other people. But they killed him. This man Rumi, who is towards the west, remember Jesus said, lightning strike in the east, but it doesn't flash there. People are against light in the east, far more against than people of the Middle East, where Jesus said, light came among his own, and his own hated light and loved darkness, and they crucified Jesus for giving the light. So Paul also came from Turkey. And this Rumi was also from Turkey. So my elder brother Shah, Royal Shah Shams Tabrizi, found him ideal to express the spiritual knowledge. So he met him in Konya, and over there he was teaching the student the dead letters for the book and scripture. And when Royal Shah Shams Tabrizi asked him, hey, my friend, what are you teaching? What are you doing? He said, I'm teaching from the books of my fathers and other things, and you don't know of this thing. Go away. So he did not go away. He took all his books and throw it to them in the water. When he threw in the water, then Rumi was angry, but he did not slap him or anything like that. He said, oh, my forefathers have written those books, you know, and they were very valuable to me. Same will be to these university professors. If they find an old document, they will pay millions of pounds to buy that one. That is how they value the old documents. This Gospel of Thomas and all that, you know, they have got it, but they can't interpret it because they don't have the Holy Spirit, which is common sense. The men of dead letters, they go by what is written. That's why Jesus gave the His word, the Oral Torah, in parables, puzzles, to sharpen the mind of His brethren. Jesus had no disciple. The root of the word disciple is discipline. Rabbis, Pharisees, Sadducees, they discipline their intake of the natural voice, by teaching them the moral of Moses. So they had disciples, but not Jesus. And they used to say prayer in which the Father is in heaven. Father is Yahweh, which is in heaven. But those who are twice born, they know Father lives in his temple, this one here. So the gospel comes from your heart and not from the book. So here is the I've written something that will clarify. So this is the relationship between scripture and the oral Torah, which is his word. Rumi was having his book, scripture, and he was just vomiting out what his forefathers and other people have written without understanding. So my elder brother came, Royal Shah Shams Tabrizi. He took all his books, you know, put them and throw them into the water. They are good for nothing. But Rumi was not happy. He said, "Ah, my old books, my forefather written this one, that one, you know. Without those books, I'm good for nothing. I can't say a word out of my mouth before, without those books." So then my royal elder brother, Royal Shah Shams Tabrizi, took one book by one, full of dust, buried in the ground as if they were buried in the graveyard, and dusted them and handed over to him, dry, not a speck of water spoiling anyone. So Rumi was surprised, you know, how he is getting these books dry. Then he asked my elder brother, Royal Shah Shams Tabrizi, "What is that? What type of knowledge is this?" Then my elder brother said, "This knowledge you don't know. This is the knowledge of heart and not of the book." So this is the knowledge of heart, the oral Torah. This is of the book. This you see, or this you perceive. That's why Jesus said, people see, read the book, but not perceive. So here is the royal kingdom of God, to which Jesus opened the narrow gate. The scripture, they were up to John the Baptist. Luke 16, verse 16, law and prophets were till John the Baptist. After that one, no more law, but the Holy Spirit. No more law, but Holy Spirit, which is common sense. So use common sense, the books to be put aside. 2 Corinthians 3, when Paul was preaching gospel, he told the people, "I'm not flashing degrees that I'm student of Jerusalem University. I have PhD this and that, as these people in Rumi forum." The one who is heading, a lady, she has so many degrees she has, flashing those degrees. The gospel cannot be written down in ink on paper, but over the living tablet of heart here, through logical reasoning. That brute logo, and logo is his word. So here, John the Baptist, all the letter finish here. So this is the age of Christ. So no book is allowed here. That is the Jewish level. The Bible is the Jewish level, is not allowed here. No money, in your pocket, no two shoes, no tunic, no greedy people, and no script. Script means scripture, forbidden. Because here our covenant is of Holy Spirit, which is common sense. So, which is common sense here, and no law and proof. So to enter this one, this is a narrow gate, which is low for the humble and narrow for the solitary. You have to be twice born to enter this one. The once born people can't enter it because they can't find this gate. Once born people are caught by rabbis, Pharisees, Sadducees, Pope, these hireling doctor priests in the churches, they catch them. So they make them slaves. That is called, unless a female becomes a male, that means slave is a female, like in the house, master and missus. So master is the rabbi or the priest, and the one who is in the church, doing what the rabbi tell them to do, or the priest will tell them to do. They are female. So unless you become male, independent thinker, you can't enter into this royal kingdom of God. And this you become when you sow the tribal seed in the soil. So the ego of the tribal seed is burned. Remember that the chosen people, they were so proud of being the sons of Abraham that they will, when St. James the Just was telling them that in God, there is neither male nor female, not Jew or Gentile, we are all one. The temple priest wasn't happy that he is making the Jew equal to the Gentile. So they told St. James the Just, this Passover, you go to the pinnacle and tell everyone that we are equal, each one is equal. He said, no problem. So he went up to the pinnacle to proclaim that in God, we are neither male nor female, not Jew nor Gentile, we are all equal. And when they said equal, then those rabbis, the psychic, twice born psychic, evil spirited, they told their stooges, once born, look, look, he is making us equal to the Gentile. So they told them to go up and throw him down. He is speaking against us. So they went up and threw him down, and he broke his legs, and then somebody with a stick, you know, fuller's stick, you know, he hit his head and killed him. So that is how they were hitting light. So in Jesus, we have one Father, and we are all sons of the God. Whether in flesh you are a male or a female, doesn't matter. So the son represents father, not the daughter. So here we are all sons of God. You enter this one, you bury the ego of your tribal seed, that I'm a chosen person, and the other are Gentile, or they are other type, you know, you bury it down here. Then you turn it into a plant which is twice born. You want to have a wheat, then you put a wheat seed into the soil. And when the seed then germinate, or when a person becomes twice born, then the seed slowly disappear. Same way when you become twice born, you enter this fold, and His word will burn the ego. As you grow spiritually, then this ego is burned by by His word. And then you are made humble, and preacher. Here are preachers, here are teachers. Here everyone has his own mother and father. Here we have one father. We are all brethren. Here we exercise love called agape. And here is arrows. Moses created arrows in the wilderness. No more rift, or the snake was lifted up. And here is the agape on an international basis. So we lift the cobras off among the nations. So here, people who hate others on the basis of their color or the origin of their country, they are anti-Christ or they are racist. They cannot enter into this fold here. So to enter this fold, you must be humble and know that we have one Father, we are all sons of the Most High. That's why Jesus came to make us. Sons can enter the house of the Father as they like it. But the slaves, they are not allowed to enter the house. They sit at the door. So remember, Jesus had 70 outer circle laborers. They were prepared for the rabbis, Pharisees, Sadducees, or in the name of John the Baptist, moral teachers. Stephen was one of them, and they were angel prophets and not saint. So they were sitting at the door of our supernatural Father, singing the praises of our supernatural Father. Remember when Jesus baptized the 11 at the Last Supper, which is a Eucharist, you know. Remember, Jesus threw Judas Iscariot out because he was stealing money from the purse. He was a thief. He loved mammon, not God. Same as the diabolical preachers in the churches. They work for mammon and not for God. So if you tell them gospel truth, oh, they will hate it. I tried it. They don't want to know me. Even Oxford University people, they throw me out of a seminar which was Christian and Jewish because of my this t-shirt. Oh, students don't like this t-shirt. I can't sit in the seminars. And they wanted me to put on plain clothes. I told them this is the light on the living lampstand. No, they won't listen to me. They throw me out. So this is how the people today in universities and colleges, they hate gospel truth. I go to Faraday's Society in Cambridge. I used to go there annually, you know. I attended a couple of them to see if they will have any open-mindedness. So no, they had no way. And there the dog collar which they were dominating. Doctors, they are bound by the law. They get a license. As these rabbis at the time of Jesus were getting license. And they could only teach the moral laws. And transgression against the moral is sin. And that's why they had the authority to forgive the sins. And not Christ Jesus. Because he had no degree from the University of Jerusalem on theology. That's why the woman caught in adultery was brought to him to give the judgment so that they can catch him and tell the temple high priest, hey, look, this man has no degree and no license and he is doing this, he gives this verdict. Jesus, knowing the matters of their heart, he told them, the one who haven't sinned, let him throw the first stone. So they all run away. Then when he was sitting at the temple, and those people were grinding their teeth that we could not catch him, then Jesus opened his mouth, that you by becoming unfaithful to Abraham, unfaithful to Yahweh, when you become Jew outwardly. Jew is one who is inwardly, spiritual, not outwardly. So when you become Jew outwardly, you broke your covenant with Abraham and Yahweh. So you are liars, killer, murderer. Remember, they wanted to kill Joseph, for he was telling the truth to Jacob. So he told them, you are liars and murderers. So your forefathers, they were super bastard fanatic devils. And when he called them super bastard, to this they retorted, oh, we are born of legitimate parents. Jesus said, that's true, but when you become Jew outwardly, you become a fanatic, super bastard fanatic. As in India, during partition, how people of the same tribe, they kill each other because they have been given the coloring of Hindu, Sikh and Muslim, of appearance and not of heart, and they killed each other. So of heart is not easy to get it by the grace of our supernatural Father. Only He can give you knowledge of heart. No man can give you. Christ Jesus came to deliver the knowledge of the heart. And that's what He said. He's like a sower, sowing seeds. Some fell on flat ground, footpaths which are once born. And some fell on rocky soil. There are twice born people who are doubting, like Judas Iscariot. They loved money. They became psychic. They had their following, they made a following. And some fell on the soil, but the weeds choked it, like me working from home. And the family affairs and other things, you know, they choke the produce. I can't produce 100%, you know. But those who leave their families, as the 12 did, and joined hands with Christ Jesus to preach the gospel, and they could produce 100% fruit. So you should try your best while you are in the house to preach the gospel, because time ahead is this, you know. This is the American Jew, having the sickle, which is David's cross. They are the ones who are causing all bloodshed in different countries. And the atomic war is coming soon. In 2023, 14 May 2023, is the last protection to Israel. And after that, there is no protection. Israel will not see its 76th birthday. So atomic war is not far away. Soon after 14 May 2023, and before atomic war takes place, the people will be divided, pro-Russia and pro-America. And there will be intense war for 6 months. 6 months are the sixth candle of the menorah, and on the seventh month will be the judgment, which is of God, because the seventh candle, middle candle, belongs to God. So you can see what is going to happen. It's not far away. So here it is. These six candles are the secular people. Social, ecumenical, political affair, holy and evil. The middle candle is of Elohim, Allah, Parbrahm. And the sun of the middle candle is Christ. That's why Christ is the Lord of the Sabbath. That's why John the Baptist said, I can't touch your shoe even, never mind baptizing you. But Jesus said, for the sake of ritual, you should do it. Because that's your field, the body of moral laws. When John the Baptist baptized Jewish men in water, he baptized them in the name of Abraham. And when he baptized Jesus, he baptized them in the name of his father, Yahweh. Mary was sired by Yahweh. And so, he was the second Adam. Mary was surrogate mother. And he, Joseph, foster father. Much more you can all these learn from here. The book can't teach you what you know from God. God teaches us. God lives in his temple. So we turn our face to God and not to the public. Politicians turn their face to the public and they say things the public likes it, or the sugar-coated sermons. We don't say sugar-coated sermon. We say what pleases our Father, whether you like it or not. So this Rumi's forum, headed by a professor in dead letters, and Nanak, the second commander, Jesus said, they are super donkeys carrying holy books. So you can see what type of knowledge you can get from these professors. So be careful and ask these agents over there simple question to these people who are heading such things, are the religious preachers. Why Allah is called Allah? Or what is the origin of the word Allah? Let me know if somebody can give you the answer, the one who has the answer, and he knows the Islam of Allah. This Islam which is going on now of Sharia is of Ismullah. Nothing to do with Allah. My elder brother Royal Shah Shams Tabrizi came to preach the gospel of Allah. And the mullah did not like it, because what applied to flesh, the opposite to spirit. And that's why the temple priest from Jerusalem went to the house of Jesus to tell Mary, what your son is doing is opposite to our custom. In rabbi or other thing, ego is boosted. While in Christ Jesus, ego is buried in the soil, completely. So we are one father, and we are all his sons. Whether in flesh you are a male or female, doesn't matter. Whether you are white or Negro or anything, doesn't matter. So this is my request to these Rumi forum people, not to get a university professor to lead them. Because they are spiritually dead. They are spiritually blind. And how can a blind person lead the forum of Rumi, who is enlightened by Royal Shah Shams Tabrizi? Our Father God bless you, and hope my message is clear, but you can watch my videos on YouTube. I put a few on this Rumi and my royal elder brother, Royal Shah Shams Tabrizi. He was not Shah Shams Tabrizi, but royal. Royal gave it free, freely received, freely given. No money charge. Those people who charge money in the name of God, they are crook. Sometimes you find people in the post, you know, oh, we are doing this thing, that thing, you know, donations. And when you ask those people where the donation go, what do they do for a living? They will show you the dog collar. We are here to, as priest, explaining the scripture to the people. In Judaism, we don't need scripture. Scripture, people holding Bible are in their hands, are putting Bible in the hand of St. Paul or Christ Jesus, making them Antichrist. So they are Antichrist. But they go there to the temple or other things, churches, and the priests like it because they give them money. Without money, they won't talk. So when you work for God, you are paid in gospel treasures, and not in mammon treasures. So our Father God blesses you.